friends, welcome back to my channel, and welcome if you are new here. It is meal prep time. It is not meal prep Monday, it is meal prep Tuesday. As you know, if you follow my channel, I was in Vegas over the weekend, which was amazing. So much fun, a well-needed little getaway, vacation, away from everything. It was awesome. I spent it with my best friend. We had a really, really good time. So I am here now with my meal prep for the week. So I did prep 4 meals. For the most part, I did make 5 lunch preps just because I like to have an extra one on hand just in case I need a quick, easy, on-the-go dinner or another meal during the week. So I have a breakfast, I have a lunch, and I have a sweet, absolutely delicious treat for you. So if you want to see what I have in store for you for this week's WW Weekly Meal Prep, just stay tuned. For my breakfast this week, I'm going to be making peanut butter, chocolate chip, overnight oats, and I'm just going to pair this with some fruit and eggs. So that portion will be 0. So let me show you what is in my overnight oats. You're going to need some almond milk or whatever milk that you choose to do. I'm gonna do this Califia Farms unsweetened almond milk. Oatmeal, make sure you choose the whole oats, not the quick cook oats for this recipe. Any type of sweetener of your choice, I'm gonna be using the Lakanto Monkfruit. I do get a lot of questions on this big bag of this sweetener. I got this at Costco, so check your local Costco or Sam's Club for these large bags of Monkfruit sweetener. Also some PB2, some maple syrup. I'm gonna be using the Joseph's sugar-free maple syrup. This I bought off of the nutrition website. This is hands down the best syrup there ever. It's amazing. You guys, it is so good. It's so thick and it tastes like real non-sugar-free decadent syrup. If you're interested in checking out Nutrition, there's quite a few great WW items. There is a link down in the description box, so check it out. Highly recommend adding Joseph's syrup to your cart because it's amazing. And then I'm gonna need some chocolate chips, so I'm gonna be doing these Bake Believe semi-sweet chocolate chips. I purchased these at Walmart, and these are pretty awesome. They are big, full-size chocolate chips, and they taste delicious. They're sweetened with stevia. They really are all natural and they are delicious. So I'm gonna be adding some of those. We'll also need some chia seeds. And last but not least, some really ripe bananas. So let's get started on our chocolate peanut butter overnight oats. So to put together our overnight oats, I have my ball jar. Now mine is pretty small, which is just fine because it helps keep the points a little lower. Overnight oats can be a little point heavy. So having a smaller jar, it keeps portions and points in control. So the first thing I'm gonna do is add just a little bit of almond milk to the bottom of my jar and maybe about a tablespoon and a half. That way there's some liquid in the bottom before I add my dry ingredients. Next, I'm going to add 1/4 cup of rolled oats. And that is exactly why I wanted that milk at the bottom, so that it has a chance for the oatmeal to kind of soak into the milk. And then I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of PB2 directly on top of my oats. And then I'm going to add 1/2 tablespoon of the Lakanto Monk Fruit sweetener. I'm going to add 1/2 tablespoon of chia seeds. And then I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of the chocolate chips. And then lastly, I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of my Joseph's maple syrup directly to the top. And then we're gonna fill the rest of our jar with a ripe banana. So I did mention in the beginning that I would have a fruit, but I won't, because this is actually my fruit. So we're gonna take the ripe banana, and this is a pretty small one. Make sure you get, you know, the kind that will fit into your mason jar. Go ahead and add your banana to the top there, and I just kind of squish it down the best that I can to try to get it soaked in a little bit with all of the liquid. And then the last thing I'm gonna do is just top my jar with the last little bit of almond milk. I just wanna make sure that I have enough liquid for my oats. And then we'll go ahead and pop our lid on, and I'll show you guys what this looks like up close. It's that easy. Overnight oats is super easy. And look at this, you guys. Look at that deliciousness. Chia seeds, chocolate, oatmeal, yum. And then I usually give it a pretty good shake because I do want to make sure that I get liquid mixed throughout all of the dry ingredients in my overnight oats. And that's it, you guys. Look at how yummy that looks. So we're just going to throw these in the refrigerator, and then the next day I'll pair this with some eggs, and that'll be my breakfast.
I get so caught up in the middle, thinking of drowning in those blue eyes. I'm losing sight cause I am falling. I'm so deep down, deep down. And it's not a lie.
All right, here are my overnight oats, you guys. These look incredible. You can see all of the goodness in there of the banana, the chocolate chip, the oatmeal. Oh, it looks so good. So each day I'm going to have one of my overnight oats, and I'm just going to pair that with some eggs. So on the mornings that I can cook eggs at home, I will. Otherwise, I'll have 1 to 2 hard-boiled eggs, and that'll be a perfect balance of protein and oatmeal to keep me full. So these overnight oats, the way that I have prepared them, are 5 smart points each. So you can't beat that. Pair that with some eggs, and you have a 5 smart point delicious, protein-filled, sweet treat breakfast. For my lunches this week, I'm gonna be making tater tot casserole. And according to the internet, because you know all things on the internet are true, this is the best tater tot casserole ever. So I'm very excited about this. It is a little bit point heavy, so this is going to be all that I'm going to be having for lunch, with the exception of some fruit. So let me show you what is in our tater tot casserole. You're going to need some salt and pepper, Worcestershire sauce, a can of green beans, and a can of corn, cheddar cheese soup, and fat-free cream of mushroom soup, fat-free sour cream. You can even do light sour cream, whatever you prefer. Tater tots, of course. You can either do a fresh onion chopped up or minced onion. I'm just going to do minced onion. Garlic powder, fat-free cheddar cheese, and lastly, a pound of 96-4 extra lean ground beef. So let's get started on the best ever tater tot casserole. So the first thing we're doing for our tater tot casserole is we're gonna brown up our ground beef with our spices and our Worcestershire sauce. So I'm going to add a little bit of garlic powder to my ground beef. I'm also going to add my minced onion. This is also where you would add in your raw onion if you did go ahead and cut it into pieces. That way it can saute down with the ground beef. We're also going to be adding in our Worcestershire sauce. You know I generally don't measure, so I'm just gonna kinda eyeball that, and that's gonna give the ground beef a really delicious kinda smoky flavor. And then lastly, we're gonna add in some salt and pepper, and we're gonna let this ground beef cook down and get nice and brown. My hamburger is coming right along. While it is browning, I have my pan with my steamer basket. I'm gonna go ahead and bring this water to a boil, and I'm gonna go ahead and steam some broccoli. This is just fresh broccoli florets. I'm gonna steam that up so that I can have that as an extra vegetable alongside my tater tot casserole. So I'll let that kind of steam up while our hamburger is continuing to cook. So next up for our tater tot casserole is I went ahead and put my drained extra lean ground beef into a bowl here. To that, I am going to add my entire drained can of green beans. We're also going to add our entire drained can of corn. And I'm just gonna kinda mix this as I go, just to make sure everything gets nice and incorporated together, because our bowl's gonna be pretty full once we add in all the rest of our ingredients. I'm also going to add 1/3 cup of fat-free sour cream. So there's 1/3 cup of that. Now again, you can do light sour cream. It probably won't change the points, but just be safe and recalculate your points if you do go that route. I'm also going to add my entire can of fat-free, or 98% fat-free cream of mushroom soup. I do get a lot of questions. People will say, well, I don't like mushrooms. Can I substitute another soup? Absolutely. You could do cream of mushroom or cream of chicken in here, and I don't think that it would really do much change for the taste if you are not a fan of mushrooms. And then we're also going to add our can of the cheddar cheese soup as well. Oh, yum. You guys, this looks pretty good. Maybe they're right that this is the best ever tater tot casserole. So let's go ahead and get that can of cheddar in there. And then lastly, we are going to add 1 cup or half of our bag of fat-free shredded cheese. And then we're gonna give this a huge mix, get everything nice and combined together. And then we'll be ready to put this into our 9x13 baking dish. We'll top it with those tater tots and we'll get this into the oven. But I'm telling you, it smells pretty darn delicious. Once you have your tater tot casserole mixture nice and combined, we are going to take a 9x13 baking dish, spray it with some nonstick cooking spray. To that, we are going to go ahead and add in our mix. So we just want to spread it evenly along the bottom of our baking dish. I did set my oven to 350 degrees. We are going to bake this for about 50 minutes or until our tater tots are nice and crispy and our casserole is really bubbly. That's how we'll know that it's done. And then we'll remove it and top it with the rest of our cheese and throw it back into the oven for about 5 more minutes to get that cheese nice and melted. So let's get this spread out. So we are getting a nice dose of vegetables at least in this between the corn and the beans. And then I'm double dosing with my broccoli. So this should be a pretty substantial, delicious lunch. So get that spread out along the bottom. Ugh, yum. And then we are going to top our casserole with our tater tots. We are going to use this entire bag of tater tots. And basically what I want to do is I just want to evenly put them over the top of my casserole. So I'm just gonna toss them on there until my entire casserole is covered with these delicious tater tots.
Deep down, and it's not a lie that I die.
And here is our tater tot casserole, you guys. I have a feeling this is gonna be pretty delicious. So I'm gonna go ahead and get this in my 350 degree oven for about 50 minutes. So I pulled out my tater tot casserole. It's been in there about 50 minutes. Look at how good that looks, you guys. I'm gonna go ahead and top it with the rest of my fat-free shredded cheese. And then I'm just gonna throw this back into the oven for about another 5 minutes. I just wanna let the cheese get a little bit melty on top. And then I'll be back to show you our completed casserole. We'll get it into some meal prep containers. I'll show you what I'm having for lunches and give you the smart points. And here is our tater tot casserole. This looks so good. I'm gonna allow it to rest for just a few minutes. It is 8 servings, so I'm gonna cut it up into 8 equal servings, put it in my meal prep container with my broccoli, and I'll give you the smart points for my entire lunch, and then we'll move on to our pumpkin fluff. All right, so here's my lunches for the week. So you can see here, I have 1/8 of the tater tot casserole. You guys, it's a large serving. I was thinking it might be kind of small for the points, but it is large, it's hearty. I did taste it, and you guys, I have to say, this is the best tater tot casserole I have ever had. It is so creamy, so full of flavor, it's incredible. Definitely make this. So I have 1/8 of the tater tot casserole. Some of the steamed broccoli, I'll just add some spray butter, salt, and pepper, since the main point of my lunch is pretty high. So this is my lunch, so 1/8 of the tater tot casserole is 8 smart points. I know that's a little bit point heavy, but you guys, it's so good. It is so worth it. It's hearty, it's comfort food. Oh, I'm so excited, so excited. 0 for the broccoli, 0 for the grapes. So my entire lunch, 8 smart points. For a sweet treat this week, I'm gonna be making some pumpkin fluff. And this is just going to be a sweet dessert, low points. I've had this before, it's delicious. So I wanted to make it for you guys, give you the recipe. So you're going to need some light or fat-free Cool Whip, whatever you wanna use. They're all really similar in points. Also, some sugar-free pudding. I'm gonna be using the cheesecake, only just because I don't have any vanilla, but the recipe calls for vanilla. Pure pumpkin, and then I'm gonna be using the Dax pumpkin pie spice because, as you know, this is my all-time favorite. I love Dax, you guys. It is the best. It is zero salt, nothing artificial, all natural, no MSG. This one is literally spices, honey, and, oh, cinnamon. Cinnamon, spices, and honey. That's it. So these are great before weigh-in, great if you're watching your sodium intake. They have over 20 spice options. I have them all, they're amazing. If you're interested in DAX, I will put my code here on the screen. Down in the description box is a link, just click it. Enter my code at discount and at checkout and you'll get 10% off and free shipping. So you can't beat it. Highly, highly recommend. This pumpkin spice is hands down my very, very favorite pumpkin ever. I mean, it's so incredibly delicious. So I'm definitely going to be adding some of that. So this is everything that's in my pumpkin fluff. For our pumpkin fluff, the first thing that we're gonna do is add our package of the sugar-free pudding mix. And again, I'm using the cheesecake flavor, but you can really use vanilla or whatever flavor you want. You could even do chocolate. And then I'm going to add my entire tub of my Cool Whip. Make sure that you do let it thaw a little bit. Mine is still a bit frozen, but not too terribly bad. And then we're just gonna kind of give that a quick preliminary mix with our pudding. And then we are going to add in our entire can of our pumpkin puree. And then the last thing is that pumpkin spice. And you guys, literally, you mix this together and it makes this delicious, sweet, low point, mousse-like dessert. And you can put this in a pie crust. Graham cracker pie crust would be super good. And you could make a mock pie and that would be delicious. Or you can just eat it in a parfait glass with a little bit of whipped cream on top, and voila, you guys have a delicious low point dessert. So I'm gonna get this all mixed together and I'll be back to show you what our completed fluff looks like, and I'll give you all of the smart points. And there is our pumpkin fluff, you guys. I tasted a little bit of this. It is so delicious. Where has this been all my life and why have I not been making this all fall? Because this is absolutely positively delicious. So it makes 4 to 6 servings depending on how much you want to have. I am going to actually divide this into 4 servings. So for the pumpkin fluff, if you divide it into 4 servings, it is 3 smart points per serving. So that's not bad at all because that's quite a lot for 3 smart points. And again, you can top it with a little bit of fat-free Ready Whip with a drizzle of that pumpkin pie spice from DAX, and what an amazing dessert. So 1/4, 3 smart points. You can bet this is what I'm having for dessert tonight. So here are my snacks that I'm gonna be having this week. Changing it up a little bit. I've been craving a couple things, so I'm gonna make it into a snack for the week. So first, I'm gonna be having some hard-boiled eggs. I love these hard-cooked eggs from Trader Joe's. They are seriously so good, you guys. I don't know what it is about them, but they are so good. So I'm gonna be having those as a snack, and of course, those are 0 smart points. Sometimes I eat the yolk, sometimes I don't, but it is nice to have a healthy, protein-filled 0-point snack. I'm also going to do this combination. I know this might sound weird, but it's delicious. And what it is low fat or fat free, whatever kind of cottage cheese that you like. And these thinnables from Fiber Gourmet, which I buy these off of the Nettrition website. You guys have to check that website out. Same website that I buy my syrup, my Fiber Gourmet pasta, my sugar-free honey. It is such an amazing website. These thinnable crackers are so good. This is the sharp cheddar. They are a dupe for the Cheez-Its. And you can have 60 crackers, 60, you guys, 2 smart points. And they are just as good as the Cheez-Its that are 5 smart points. So what I like to do is I take 1/2 cup of cottage cheese and 1 serving of these thinnables, and I like to dip the thinnables in the cottage cheese, or I put them in and mix it together. It is so good. So good. It's a 4 smart point snack. So good because it gives me some fiber, which these crackers have quite a bit of fiber, 12 grams per serving, and 4 grams of protein. So I'm getting a big blast of protein and fiber for 4 smart points. So good, you guys. There is a link down in the description box for Nettrition. Go check it out. There's hundreds of WW recipes. They are all so good. And thinnables is one thing you should definitely add to your cart. So that is 1 snack and hard-boiled eggs. And then of course, I'm going to be having a Built Bar. As you know, this is my morning snack every day. It keeps me full, keeps me satisfied, cures that little bit of a sweet tooth that I can get mid-morning. So good. I love Built Bars. So this week I'm going to have the Mint Brownie Delight. You guys know this is one of my favorites. It is chewy, ooey, gooey like a brownie. So good. Also the Black Cherry Chocolate. I really enjoyed this one as well. Very reminiscent of chocolate covered cherries in those boxes you get at Christmas. Whatever, the red box. I don't know what brand it is. So good. And then I have the Mocha Chocolate Cream. If you love coffee and chocolate, my friends, you will love this one. And then I have the brand new peanut butter that I'm obsessed with. This tastes so good. The consistency of this is a lot different than the regular Built Bar. It's not as marshmallowy. My favorite way to eat the peanut butter is cold. I think it brings out the peanut butter flavor a little bit more than if you have it warm. And there are real chunks of peanut butter, or I'm sorry, of peanuts in there. And it is made with organic peanut butter. You guys, so incredibly delicious. This particular Built Bar is 4 points. Just keep that in mind. All of the rest are 3. And then, of course, the pumpkin pie. I had to order myself a full box because I love the pumpkin pie. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. If you're interested in the pumpkin pie, make sure you head on over to Built Bar as soon as possible and order it because it's only while supplies last. So 3 smart points for all of the Built Bars with the exception of the peanut butter, but it's so worth the point. I will give you 1 point for peanut butter any day of the week. These are amazing. My code is here on the screen. It'll give you 10% off and free shipping. They have a sample box if you want to try out the Built Bars before you invest in a full box. But I guarantee you'll be back for a full box because they're that delicious. So this is my morning snack, and then this is my afternoon snacks, and those are my snacks for the week. Thank you for joining me on another weekly WW meal prep. Let me just tell you guys, those overnight oats are stellar. They are delicious. They're the perfect sweetness with that peanut butter. Absolutely great. And that Tater Tot Casserole, you guys have to make that. They weren't lying when they said the best ever Tater Tot Casserole. It was so good and filling, super filling. I was a little nervous about it being a little bit high in points, but it was so filling. It was perfect for a lunch. And let's talk a moment about that pumpkin fluff. So good. So incredibly good. These 3 recipes are absolute positive must makes. Try them out. They're family friendly. Husband approved. He loved everything. He actually ate the leftover tater tot casserole. So definitely husband approved. So if you're new to my channel, welcome. I do a weekly meal prep generally on Monday, which I refer to as meal prep Monday. But again, because of my trip, I am uploading today, Tuesday. Every week I bring you some new recipes that are WW friendly and of course that are delicious. So make sure that you subscribe and you hit that little bell so you're notified whenever I upload a new video. Thumbs up this one and comment down below. Let me know which of these recipes are you absolutely excited to try. Maybe it's all of them. Let me know down in the comments. I absolutely love hearing from you guys. Thank you again so much for watching. Stay tuned a little later this week for my Vegas vlog. It was so fun, you guys. I can't wait to share it with you. And I'll see you all in my next video. Bye, guys.